us being thrown into jail or prison. And then the Lord said something to me that was so amazing. The prison experience was never for Paul and Silas. It was actually for the jailer and his family. Can I tell you that the best place to get information from is experience? And so it took a prison experience, being sentenced to about 10 years, being released about after 3 years and something, for me to walk in purpose, understanding that I was not just created between chapter 1 and chapter 10 for mistakes, mess, and a prison experience, but I was created for purpose. Amen. And it didn't matter where purpose came into fruition. What mattered was that I got the information and I made use of it. And so today I stand here as someone who is very, very passionate about change, who is passionate about giving ex-convicts a second chance because they're human, who is passionate about getting to the root of what caused the problem for somebody to be incarcerated in the first place. My incarceration was never prison. Prison was where I got freedom. My incarceration was my mind, because I was my greatest enemy. I was imprisoned mentally, emotionally, and soul-wise way before I got to prison. But it took being confined to a prison sentence for God to truly get the opportunity, while I was quiet and confined, to begin a work in me. And no, I'm not perfect. I'm still on the road going to perfection. But as I get there, I plan to pull some people with me. Amen. And so today, as a minister of the gospel, I don't just believe in theory. I believe in practical. And so I believe in programs to help persons to not just be their best, but to continue to be their best and impact others' lives, even with their messy story. A mess can be a message. All you have to do is sit down and allow God to put the A, the G, the E, and turn it into a message. Your pain is what? God bless you. Thank you.